Good afternoon. This is All India Radio and I'm Saira Mujtaba with the Midday News. The headlines. Governing Council of NITI Aayog to meet for the first time in Prime Minister Narendra Modi's second tenure in New Delhi today. Resident doctors of AIIMS Delhi resume work amidst ultimatum to West Bengal Government to resolve the issue of striking doctors within 48 hours. Air Force Chief BS Dhanoa says data of voice recorders of crashed AN-32 aircraft being analysed to prevent recurrence of such incidents. India to clash with South Africa in the title clash of the Hockey Men Series Finals at Bhubaneswar this evening. And in ICC Cricket World Cup, Australia take on Sri Lanka while South Africa face Afghanistan. Governing Council of NITI Aayog will meet for the first time in Prime Minister Narendra Modi's second tenure in New Delhi today. Our correspondent has the details.
The agenda before the 5th Council meeting include rainwater harvesting, drought situation and relief measures, aspirational districts program, transforming agriculture with special emphasis on Agriculture Produce Marketing Committee APMC Act, an Essential Commodities Act and security-related issues with specific focus on left-wing extremism districts. The Governing Council will review the action taken on the agenda items of the previous meeting and deliberate upon the future developmental priorities. The Governing Council of NITI Aayog comprises the Prime Minister, Chief Minister of all states, Lieutenant Governors of Union Territories and other special invitees. The Governing Council presents a platform to discuss intersectoral, interdepartmental and federal issues in order to accelerate the implementation of the National Development Agenda in the spirit of Ek Bharat, Shrestha Bharat. Anupam Mishra, AI News, Delhi.
Ahead of the meeting, senior Congress leader and former Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh met with Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Kamal Nath, Rajasthan Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot, Karnataka Chief Minister H.D. Kumarasamy and Puducherry Chief Minister V. Narayan Sami in New Delhi today. They discussed the proposed agenda and issues of the states governed by the Congress and its allies to be taken up with the Prime Minister in today's meeting. Chief Ministers of Chhattisgarh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Puducherry, Meghalaya and Nagaland called on Prime Minister Narendra Modi at his residence in New Delhi today. The meeting has been described as a courtesy call on the Prime Minister. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will share his thoughts with the people in India and abroad in his Mann Ki Baat program of All India Radio on the 30th of this month at 11 a.m. It will be the first Mann Ki Baat episode after Mr. Modi assumed office for the second time. In a tweet, Mr. Modi said, he and the countrymen will meet once again through the radio to share joy, positivity and celebrate the collective strength of 130 crore Indians. People can share their innovative suggestions and insights directly with the Prime Minister through the Narendra Modi app Open Forum and MyGov Open Forum. People can also dial the toll-free number 1-800-117-800 and record the message for the Prime Minister in either Hindi or English. Minister of State for Finance and Corporate Affairs Anurag Thakur is chairing the pre-budget consultations with the representatives of digital economy and startups today. This is being done in connection with the forthcoming General Budget 2019-20. Consultations with trade unions and labour organisations are scheduled later in the day. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman had met with leading economists yesterday. The main areas of discussion included boosting economic growth, job-oriented growth, increased macroeconomic stability, fiscal management and increase in investments. Ms. Sitharaman will present the budget on the 5th of next month. Resident doctors of AIIMS Delhi have resumed work amidst ultimatum to West Bengal government to resolve the issue of striking doctors within 48 hours. In a statement, the Resident Doctors Association or RDA said it would be forced to resort to indefinite strike at AIIMS from Monday if the demands are not met. A delegation of Indian Medical Association met Union Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan over the ongoing strike of doctors in West Bengal. The strike of the protesting medical practitioners in West Bengal entered its fifth day today. turning down Chief Minister's request to meet her at the State Secretariat today. The junior doctors of Neel Ratan Sarkar Medical College and Hospital urged Ms. Mamata Banerjee to visit the hospital and apologize for terming the protesters as outsiders. A few senior doctors had met the Chief Minister last evening, but with no apparent solution. This is All India Radio giving you the news. For quick news updates round the clock, follow us on Twitter at AIR News Alerts. Air Force Chief Marshal Birinder Singh Dhanoa today said the Air Force is probing the details of what led to the recent crash of AN-32 aircraft in Arunachal Pradesh. The Air Chief Marshal was talking to reporters on the sidelines of the combined graduation parade at the Air Force Academy at Dandigal near Hyderabad. He said data of voice recorders of crashed AN-32 aircraft are being analysed to prevent recurrence of such incidents.
We have recovered flight data recorder and the cockpit voice recorder, and we'll go into the detail as to what happened and how do we make sure that it doesn't happen again. In Arunachal Pradesh, the way we fly, the terrain is very treacherous and most of the time it is cloudy. But we have our procedures to make sure that this does not happen. So we need to review as to what happened and we don't have such an accident again.
Total 152 flight cadets, including 24 women, have passed out after completing their training at the academy. Naveen Kumar Reddy has been presented the President's plaque and Chief of the Air Staff Sword as he came out meritorious in the pilot's course. India has lodged a strong protest with Pakistan over its refusal to grant visa to 87 Indian pilgrims who wanted to visit the neighbouring country to observe the death anniversary of 5th Sikh Guru Arjan Dev on the occasion of Shahidi Jor Mela. Official sources said New Delhi expressed its concern at the disregard shown by the High Commission of Pakistan on the religious sentiments and devotion of the Indian pilgrims. The sources said Pakistan had unilaterally granted restrictive visa by rail only to a private group of Indian pilgrims. The External Affairs Ministry has called upon Pakistan to immediately grant visa without any restriction. Visa for the pilgrims was sought under a 1974 bilateral protocol on visit to religious shrines. Bangladesh has reiterated its commitment not to allow use of its soil for terrorist activities against India. In a joint record of communication issued in Dhaka today, at the end of 48th DG-level border conference, India and Bangladesh agreed for effective implementation of the Coordinated Border Management Plan to curb cattle and drug smuggling, illegal border crossing and trans-border crimes. In a press statement, those countries also agreed to take effective steps for preventing smuggling of arms and explosives, drugs, gold and other such items across the border. Indian delegation was led by DG BSF Rajnikant Mishra. The next round of the DG-level border conference will be held in November this year. Our correspondent has the details.
India and Bangladesh have expressed their resolve to bring down the killing incidents on the border to zero by increasing patrols on the concluding day of the 48th DG-level meeting of border security forces of the two countries in Dhaka today. Both sides decided to carry out intensive vigilance to prevent border crossing by forcibly displaced nationals from Myanmar. The two countries also agreed to declare new areas as crime-free zones in phases, beginning with Sarail region on the Tripura border with Bangladesh. Rajesh Jha, AIR News, Dhaka.
In Sri Lanka, a group of 160 defense officers and their families reached Colombo today, while the same number of Sri Lankan officers and their families are on their way to India on a familiarization visit under Defense Exchange Program. A correspondent reports that the visit is part of a high-level defense cooperation between the two neighbors and to show solidarity with Sri Lanka after Easter Sunday attacks.
This is the first time such a large defense contingent along with families from India is visiting Sri Lanka, and they will be going to Kandy and Gaul during their four-day stay. Sri Lankan contingent visit was organized for the first time last year, and they will visit Bodh Gaya, Nalanda and Rajgir during the current visit. The visit is primarily aimed at increasing interaction and bonhomie between armed forces personnel of both countries. It follows close on the visit of Prime Minister Narendra Modi to Sri Lanka on Sunday to express solidarity with Sri Lanka after Easter attacks. Santosh Kumar, News,
Hong Kong's chief executive Carrie Lam today said a divisive bill that would allow extraditions to China has been suspended. It is a major climb down from her government after a week of unprecedented protests. She told reporters that the government has decided to suspend the legislative amendment exercise. Ms. Lam said the Legislative Council will halt its work in relation to the bill until their working communication, explanation and listening to opinions is completed, and they have no intention to set a deadline for this work. Back home, elaborate arrangements are in place to deal with Cyclone Vayu in view of its likely landfall on Kutch coast in Gujarat on Monday or Tuesday. The Met Department has said Cyclone Vayu is likely to change its course and may hit the Kutch coast. It said the intensity of Vayu is likely to get reduced and may hit the coast as a cyclonic storm or a deep depression. Ahmedabad Meteorological Center Additional Director Manorama Mohanty said, it is also possible that the cyclone may weaken and dissipate in the sea itself. The state government has asked people not to panic. Additional Chief Secretary Pankaj Kumar said, the government is closely monitoring the movement of the cyclone and that necessary precautions are being taken. Cyclone Vayu had earlier skirted the Gujarat coast, affecting Gir, Somnath, Diu, Junagar areas of the state. A report.
The powerful cyclone of its time, the Vayu, has made state government, civic authorities, security forces and relief agencies swung into action right from day one. The government chalked out a very comprehensive strategy considering each stakeholder in order to reduce the difficulty during the crisis. It shifted around 3 lakh people from the low-lying areas to the safe places, which is highest displacement by the state so far. Here is a fisherman Ramesh Baria from Amreli district describing his experiences of cyclone.
प्रशासन वाले हमने गाड़ी में बिठा गए बस के अंदर फिर वहाँ से हमको राजूला कैंप में ले गए पुल के अंदर हमको रखा मेरा परिवार को सारे गांव वाले को फिर वहाँ पे खाने के लिए व्यवस्था की और हम आज हम हमारे गांव में आए काफी खुशी लगी हमें.
The humanitarian approach shown by the government, administration as well as security agencies certainly reduce the pain of the people of losing their home and help them tackle the natural disaster in a better way. With the inputs from Harish Tak, Aparna Khun, AIR News, Ahmedabad.
In Jammu and Kashmir, state administration has approved the second phase of a comprehensive plan for flood management work on the Jhelum River at a cost of over 5,400 crore rupees. More from our correspondent.
A multi-pronged strategy under Prime Minister Development Package was adopted for flood mitigation in Kashmir Valley following devastating floods of September 2014. Over 399 crores were approved in phase 1 of this strategy, and in phase 2, the detailed project report costing over rupees 5,400 crores has been submitted to the Central Water Commission. Under the long-term measures, the expertise of international agencies is employed to conduct a detailed morphological study of River Jhelum. Tariq Rather, AIR News, Srinagar.
India will clash with South Africa in the title clash of the International Hockey Federation FIH Men's Series Finals at Bhubaneswar, Odisha this evening. The match will start at 7:15 p.m. at the Kalinga Stadium. Winning their respective semi-finals, India and South Africa had set up the summit clash yesterday and sealed their berths in the Olympic qualifiers. In the ICC Cricket World Cup, defending champions Australia will take on Sri Lanka, while South Africa face Afghanistan today. The Australia-Sri Lanka game will be played in London at 3 p.m, with the South Africa-Afghanistan match scheduled to begin at 6 p.m. at Cardiff. All India Radio will broadcast live commentary on the match between Australia and Sri Lanka. It can be heard on DTH Hindi and additional frequencies from 2:30 p.m. onwards. India will play arch rivals Pakistan tomorrow in their fourth match at Manchester. In football, the Netherlands will play Cameroon and Canada meet New Zealand today in their two Group E matches of the FIFA Women's World Cup being held in France. And now, before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Governing Council of NITI Aayog to meet for the first time in Prime Minister Narendra Modi's second tenure in New Delhi today. Resident Doctors of AIIMS Delhi resume work amidst ultimatum to West Bengal Government to resolve the issue of striking doctors within 48 hours. Air Force Chief BS Dhanoa says data of voice recorders of crashed AN-32 aircraft being analysed to prevent recurrence of such incidents. India to clash with South Africa in the title clash of the Hockey Men's Series Finals at Bhubaneswar this evening. And in ICC Cricket World Cup, Australia take on Sri Lanka while South Africa face Afghanistan. And with that, we end the midday news.